Good morning to all my dear students. Today I am going to teach you SST of class 4. As I already explained you lesson 2, sources of history, today we will discuss exercise questions and question answers. Let's begin with fill in the blanks, which is on page number 23. Fill in the blanks. Number 1. There are dash types of sources of history. How many types of sources of history? 3. Literary sources are the most reliable sources of history. Stories, poems, and songs are all oral sources of history. Secondary sources are written much after an event has taken place. Literary sources are kept in state libraries and archives. Now come to question B, write true or false. Number 1. Sources can be put under 3 heads: literary, archaeological and oral. True. Painting are not sources of history. False. Historians dig up artifacts. False. Stories, poems, and songs are literary sources. False. Primary sources are documents or objects that belong to the period of our study. True. Now come to question C. Match the following. Written sources, archives, artifacts, museum, coins, archaeological source, Sachi Stupa, monument, Akbarnama, court account. Now D1 is, answer the following questions. Question number 1, what are inscriptions? What are inscriptions? Inscriptions are the writing on stone, metal or some materials as an important historical source. How are coins useful as a source of history? Answer is, coins are useful source of history because they tell us about the ruling period of a king, the economy of the kingdom and the business or trade relations with other countries. Coin can also give accurate information like the year to which they belong or about the ruler of that time. Question number 3. Discuss the 3 types of sources with examples. There are 3 types of sources. First one is literary sources, second one is archaeological sources, and third is oral sources. First, literary sources. Literary sources are written sources like books, manuscript, documents, and letters. 2. Archaeological sources. Archaeological sources are basically the material evidence like monuments, coins, artifacts, and inscriptions. Oral sources. History told in form of stories, poems, and songs to their generation is called oral history. Question number 4. Why do we need to preserve sources? We need to preserve sources because by now that we get to know about our history only by the sources. Thus, it is very important to keep these sources safe and study it carefully. What are primary and secondary sources? Primary sources are the historical documents used by historians as evidence. Example, coins, monuments, artifacts, etc. Secondary sources. secondary sources are written much after an event has taken place. Example, publications like textbook, magazine articles, etc. You have to write all these questions answer in your notebook, means in your copy. One thing more, I have to remind you that on page number 22, one web chart is there. You have to read this web chart very carefully. Thank you. Have a good day.